Now to the latest on Hokulea and Hiki'analia. The plan now is for the canoes to depart Rangiroa tomorrow morning. Apprentice navigator Jenna Ishii tells us more about their stay on this postcard-perfect atoll and why their departure might be a little tricky.
The first thing we saw at sunrise were the whole community gathering on the beach, welcoming us in, and they had a beautiful welcome ceremony with the children there, with singing and dancing and food. And since then, we've been staying in this beautiful village of Atoru, and the families here have been so kind, allowing us to stay in their homes. They've caught fish and made meals for the crew every day.
When asked, "How can we repay you?" the Rangiroa community told the crew members, "Can you connect with our kids?"
So yesterday we went to their elementary school, and the kids had planned a whole performance for us, and they had hopefully had pictures everywhere. And we taught them some songs, and that was awesome. The whole crew got to go for a couple hours.
The canoes plan on leaving tomorrow morning, and Ishii says the timing needs to be right.
It's so tricky. You can only come in and out at certain times a day. And the coolest thing with this atoll is it's a solar tide. It doesn't work with the moon. And so it's different than any other place we've been in. And the current just rages. You've got to follow the locals. So they said from 8 to 11 tomorrow we can leave.
Pretty interesting there with that tide and with the whole way that they need to get out there on time. Now, once the canoes do leave, they're going to navigate to find the little island called Matatea. And from there, they'll navigate to Papa'ete. They hope to arrive there in time for a 3 p.m. celebration planned for Sunday. It's pretty much been declared a national holiday in Tahiti, so it's going to be interesting to see that welcome.
I love those photographs of those children. So nice that they had that time to do that kind of cultural exchange.
Yeah. They're going to try to do that everywhere they go in these next 3 years.
Those still photos, so beautiful.